Hi, welcome back. In the previous video, I shared with you guys about a story of how Jerry made use of the concept of call options to purchase his dream house in Japan. So in that story, the call option that Jerry bought is valued at $10,000 and the value of the option stays constant throughout. But this is not how it works for the call options in the financial markets. So why does the value of the call option fluctuate? Let's get down to that, and trust me, the reasoning is really intuitive. Suppose on 10 September 2021, the share price of Apple is $148 and you're looking to buy a call option for Apple with a strike price of $150 expiring on 15 October 2021. So because one contract is for 100 shares, so for this call option, the total premium you have to pay is $450, which means that currently the value of this call option is $450. So you purchased this call option on 10 September 2021. So one of the factors that affect the value of options is the movement of the share price in relation to the strike price. Let's say the share price of Apple increases to $160 one week later. How will the value of the call option change? Well, in this case, the value of the call option will now increase. As an arbitrary figure, let's just say the value of the call option increases to $1,100. So why did the value of the call option increase? Think about it. From the perspective of a buyer, you want the price of Apple shares to increase above the strike price of $150 so that you are getting a good deal by fixing the price of the Apple shares at $150 should you decide to exercise the call. So in other words, you get to buy Apple shares at $150 while the other investors have to buy them at $160 off the market. So that makes a call option you hold on now more valuable now. The converse is true as well. If the price of Apple shares decreases to $140 one week later, the value of the call option declines to $100. So since you are better off by buying the Apple shares at a price that is lower than the $150 strike price, directly off from the stock market, the call option in this case is no longer that valuable to the buyer now. And if we go to the technical definition, this is what we call the intrinsic value. Intrinsic value is the difference between the strike price of the option and the current market price of the stock. Okay, but if you really cannot remember this formula, it's okay since you already understand the logic behind intrinsic value of a call option. Another factor that affects the value of the call option is the time decay or the time value. As time decays nearer to the expiration date, the value of the call option declines. Here's the reason why, and again, it works really intuitively. The longer time period you have to expiration date, it means that you have more time and more potential for the share price to move in the direction that is in your favor. Which in this case, you want the share price to move up since you are a buyer of the call option of Apple. This is also what we call the extrinsic value of the option. So as time approaches the expiration date, the extrinsic value reduces and the value of the call option declines. And there you have it, the value of a call option is the sum of the intrinsic value and the extrinsic value. Therefore, you can see that when the demand and supply of the stocks fluctuate, which in turn causes movement and volatility in the market prices, that is going to affect the value of the call options that you're holding on to. So now that you understand how and why the value of a call option can fluctuate, then comes the next big question. Why do I even need to use options? Can't I just buy the Apple shares directly off the market and save on the premium that I pay for the call option? So catch me in the next video as I'll be sharing with you why some people buy call options instead of the underlying shares itself. And I'll also be sharing with you why buyers of call options usually do not exercise the call option. Then why buy call options in the first place since they don't want to exercise it? So if you want to stay in the loop and be notified on the next video, subscribe to our channel now and turn on the notification bell. So see you in the next video.